Before we begin, I request Kanvi ma'am to present our guest lecturer for the afternoon with a bouquet as a token of our love and gratitude. Good afternoon to one and all. Thank you for being here. Today we're pleased to welcome Mr. Satyajit Bhatkal, the creator and the director of the hit TV show Satyamev Jayate. He will be sharing with us his experiences from behind the camera at the sets of the show in his lecture titled Hit Wicked, What Satyamev Jayate Taught Me. Anyone who's even remotely felt associated to the show and the issues that are discussed therein will find this lecture extremely enlightening. So now, please indulge with me as I welcome to the podium Mr. Satyajit Bhatkal. Thank you.
Hi everyone. And thank you so much, all of you all, for being here. It's lovely to be here in IIT Roorkee, and I understand that there are students from all over India, not just IIT Roorkee. So it really feels wonderful to have this opportunity to share with you a little bit of what our journey has been about. So let me tell you how I'm planning to go about this. I absolutely promise you to do no enlightening work. I want to have a chat. I'm going to be using some slides to have a conversation with you, and then I want to throw it open for questions and for discussion. So let me get into it straight away with the first slide. Ishwar, are you giving this to me? Yeah. Okay. Now, all the photography enthusiasts among you all, this is going to be sound a little, you're going to be wondering how this is connected to Satyamev Jayate, but don't worry, we'll get there. All the photography enthusiasts probably know what this is. This is what is known as a blower. You use the blower to blow on a lens in order to clean it so that there is no human contact. It doesn't leave any smudge. And I want to start with the story of the blower because this is something which goes back to my childhood when I was in school. The year was 1978. And my mama had a friend. My mama was a doctor who, he had an engineer friend who created an engineering miracle. The miracle was that this blower emitted a high frequency sound when pressed, and that high frequency sound was capable of turning on and turning off his television set. In the year 1978, there was no remote. There was only black and white television, which was on for I think 2 or 3 hours every evening. So nobody could believe that this was possible, and the entire family crowded into his house and humko laga ki yaar ye kaise hoga. So when I saw it, I saw a business opportunity out there, and I took up a bet with 3 students in my class, which was for a film and an ice cream, ki aisa kuch ho sakta hai. So my friends told me, nahi, tu fek raha hai, tu hamesha fekta hai, ye ho hi nahi sakta. So anyway, I took them to the site and I proved to them that it was technologically possible that a blower could switch a television set on and off. The important thing which I forgot to tell you is that all those 3 friends of mine went on to study at IIT. All 3 then further went to MIT and became world-renowned engineers. So how much the world has changed between 1978 and barely maybe even 5 or 6 years after that. This is a slide of the first kind of mobile phones that used to be available, simple sasta Nokia, which did the job of taking a call and receiving a call. Today, India has got 800 million phones or 800 million phone connections and something like 100 million smartphones. So the question which I want to put to you, I've told you 2 little technological bits, is that as a society, are we ready to change rapidly or not? What do you all think? Certainly technologically, as a society, we change very rapidly. We move from a time when having a landline, there used to be a black market for it, to a point where every cell phone company wants to thrust its services down our throats. So we certainly change very swiftly in some things. But do we change swiftly in everything? What is this? Now here, we're using technology. We're seeing a major newspaper. I think this is the Times of India, if I'm not mistaken. But the way people are getting married is roughly the way people used to get married maybe 3,000 years ago or 4,000 years ago, where your jati and your gotra become critical to deciding whom you may marry and whom you may not marry. So clearly we don't change in everything. Matlab cell phone fatafat le liya, lekin kuch cheeze hain ki we are not changing that fast at all. I too would have enjoyed the humor, you know, there was a nice little bit of humor and laughter when I showed you this slide. But let's have a look at the next one. This is a slide of two people, Manoj and Bubbly. They're getting married. The sad part is that they were even from the same jati, but unfortunately they belong to the same gotra, which is prohibited, as you know, in many parts of the country. And not legally, but by extra legal methods. And as a result, they were both brutally murdered. So clearly, in some things, if you try and change, it's not very funny at all. The consequences of some kinds of change in our society can be quite catastrophic for those attempting them. Now perhaps you might say ki yaar ye to shaadi wala mamla hai, shaadi ke bare mein log touchy hote hi, but otherwise na, as a society hum log fatafat change ho rahe hain yaar. Now I want to show you two more slides. The one on the left is a slide which deals with the sex ratio. Now as you know, in India we have a deteriorating and a rapidly deteriorating gender ratio, which is to say that for every 1000 men, how many women do you have? In nature it should have been 1:1, but in fact what has been happening in India is it has been steadily falling. And there are some states in India where the sex ratio, including my home state of Maharashtra, I'm ashamed to say, is below 900. That means for every 1000 boys there are less than 900 girls, which means at least 100 boys in every 1000, which is to say 10% of all boys will never ever get a partner. It is now it is statistically now an impossibility. In some states this is even larger. It has grown to 15%, for example Punjab and Haryana. In some districts it has fallen to 770, as it did once in Jhajjar. And in some communities, I'm sorry to say, it has fallen to 550. So what's happening out here is that the inequality between the genders is not improving with time. In some respects it is deteriorating. And it is deteriorating because of, ironically, the use of extremely modern technology. We have now discovered this beautiful thing called a sonography machine that can be used, which is really used to detect birth defects, but is used in fact to determine the gender of the fetus and then do what is called a sex selective abortion. In other words, if it is a girl, you abort. So in terms of hardware, we are moving forward rapidly, but where are we in terms of our software in our heads? The slide on the right is a more familiar slide. It is about dowry deaths. They continue unabated. It's the most common occurrence. The inequality between the parties at the time of marriage continues. It is just presumed that the girl side will have to host everything, pay for a dowry, and so on and so forth. So change is in fact not happening everywhere. It is in fact things are even worsening in certain other respects. Now you might say, okay, wo gender wali baat thi, kuch aur baat thi. I'm sorry to show you this slide, but this is a slide of what is known as manual scavenging, where shit is picked up by a human hand, put into a tokri and carried away on the head. And this is the occupation only of certain communities. And this still shamefully takes place in India 65 years after independence. The slide which I'm showing you is not from some village, so please don't imagine ki gaon mein hota hoga. This is in the capital city of Lucknow. So and it's far more widespread than we'd like to imagine. So now, sorry, I'm going to go back. I want to ask you all a question. I shouldn't have turned the slide, but maybe you'll I want to ask you all a question. The question is this: that some things we change very quickly. For example, the clothes we wear, we change quickly. The phones we use, the shoes we use, the cars we drive, many things we change quickly. And some things we change slowly. So what is in common between the things that we change rapidly and the things that we don't change, or in fact we go back in? Anyone would like to try? Just go ahead. I think you all have mics. Just speak into your mic.
The things which we like, we change it quickly.
Okay, the things we like, we change quickly. That's a good answer. Anyone else?
Things which improve our personality, we like to change.
The things which improve our personality, we accept quickly. And?
The things which affect only us.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. What's your name?
Ashka.
Ashka. Ashka, you absolutely hit the nail on the head. And I'm going to move to the next slide. What seems to happen is that things which are in the private sphere, which affect only us individually, we change pretty rapidly. But the things which are in the public sphere, which concern everybody collectively, over there, we are not changing our behavior. We are pretty much behaving the way we used to behave sometimes 2000 years back, 3000 years back. Jo purani aadatein ek desh ke taur par jo hamari pehli thi, aaj tak hum log usi raaste pe chal rahe hain ya kahin kahin hum log aur peeche bhi ja rahe hain. I'd like to tell you all a story. But before telling you the story, I want to tell you this. First, let me tell you the story anyway. The story is of Akbar and Birbal. And Akbar had a lot of pride in his people and their subjects and their honesty and how loyal and obedient they were to him. And Birbal thoda doubt kar raha tha ki yaar aisa hai nahi. So Akbar told Birbal, ek test kar lete hain jisse humko ye pata chale. So Birbal said, okay, we'll design a test. So the test that was designed was this. The danka pita gaya pure shahar mein aur sab logon ko ye bataya gaya ki aapko kal subah ek badi si tanki banayi gayi hai, us tanki mein aake ek lota doodh aapko usme dalna hai. To pure shahar mein danka pita gaya aur subah se logon ki line lagi thi. Akbar was triumphant. Wo dur se dekh raha tha with Birbal, and he's watching all the people, every household turned up and they poured lota after lota after lota, aur wo puri tanki bhar gayi. Log chale gaye and Akbar told Birbal, Birbal, you're a complete ass. So Birbal said, let's do one thing. Let's go and have a look at the tanki. So they got down from the palace and they walked towards the tanki. It took a good half an hour for them to reach there. And they opened up the tanki. But tanki ke andar sirf पानी ही पानी था. तो अकबर वो शॉक्ड. ही सेड कि हाउ डिड दे हैव द हिम्मत टू डू दिस. इफ दे हैड पोर्ड वाटर एंड दे हैड गॉट कॉट, आई वुड हैव चॉप्ड ऑफ देयर हेड. सो बिरबल टोल्ड हिम, यू नो व्हाट एवरी पर्सन थॉट. एवरी पर्सन थॉट कि हिज नेबर विल पुट मिल्क, मैं तो पानी डालूंगा. सो ही वाज कन्विंस्ड कि द टैंक वुड स्टिल लुक मिल्की एंड नो वन वाज गोइंग टू गेट कॉट. Unfortunately, in India, what seems to have happened with us, and I'm sorry, I'm talking to young people and I'm really not bringing great news, but this is, you know, I always believe that if we have to deal with any problem, whether it's personal, jo bhi hai, we have to look at ourselves honestly in the mirror. And it's very easy for us to say, you know, how great we are and we are the greatest nation on earth and we're the most wonderful people on earth, and there are a lot of others who will tell you that. I think what we've tried to do as a show is to have a look at the face in the mirror. And what we discovered really is that the face in the mirror needs working on. And the first step in working on is to look at that face honestly. And the more we looked at that face honestly, the more we realized that far, far, far too many of our problems, na, hum logon ko ye aadat pad gayi hai ki har cheez hum log nahi, hum bahut corruption chalta hai. Ministers corrupt hai, politicians corrupt hai, bureaucrats corrupt hai, falana corrupt hai, sab log corrupt hai, sivai hum. Now the problem is that this is not unfortunately going to take us too far in life. Because, you know, selfishness, I believe, is a virtue. I have no problems with selfishness. I think I'm selfish, and I'm sure all of us part of our survival instinct is to be selfish. So there's nothing wrong. Don't worry, I'm not going to lecture you on selflessness at all. The thing is, but selfishness should at least be intelligent. कि आप अपने selfishness को pursue करते करते आपका कम से कम फायदा तो होना चाहिए. As a nation, what has happened now is हम इस मकाम पे आप पहुंचे हैं कि जहां by being selfish we are not getting ahead, we are going behind. And I'm going to show you a slide which according to me sums up what's happening in our society, but I'll begin by telling you a little story about that slide. That slide is from a place close to where I live in Bombay. तो वहां अक्सर ये होता है कि traffic तो बहुत ज्यादा होती ही है. Bombay is infamous for bad traffic. So what happens is that this traffic going this way and this traffic coming from the opposite direction. After some time, what happens is one guy thinks, ki yaar, let me go ahead. So he opens up a third lane. The moment he opens up a third lane, the guy behind him feels ki main aur usko overtake karne ke liye fourth lane karun. The moment the fourth lane is opened up, opposite side ke dono lane abhi block ho gaye. Koi aa nahi sakta hai, ja nahi sakta hai. Sooner or later, somebody is going to come from the opposite side, and this is what happens. If you look at the slide on the right, this is a classic logjam. It means you can't go ahead, you can't go behind. And unfortunately, what seems to have happened to us as a society is that we have managed to get ourselves logjam. So by being selfish, we are not going ahead now. We are going behind. I'm going to go one slide behind on this. If you look at this, you can have the best car in the world, but if your roads are not good, you're not going to be able to use it. I have a friend with a very fancy foreign car who also happens to be my producer. And that car is absolutely no use because on Bombay's roads, every pothole and the axle touches. So actually my Maruti works much better than the Bentley. So because at least the Maruti was designed for Indian roads. So you can have the best apartment, but if outside your apartment, you're going to have that kachra ka heap, or if outside that apartment the environment is so unsafe that a woman is not safe in the evening, your wife or your girlfriend or your daughter can't take a walk comfortably, what's the use of all of this? And I think that's where we have now been getting caught for some time now. And what has our response as a society been? Our response as a society has been to look everywhere but where we should be looking. So our first response to any problem is, guess? Any problem aa gaya, aap akhbar mein kya padhenge? Ki iske liye naya kanun banna chahiye. So what we have done is that for everything in the world, we have passed laws. Do you know that India has more laws in effect than any other country in the world? I'm not joking, I used to be a lawyer for 10 years. So I say this with full confidence. In fact, we used to have in the old days, in the pre-computer days, we used to have something called the All India Reporter, which was a publisher. So they used to publish a manual of all valid central acts, and they were labeled from A to Z. And each volume was around 700-800 pages. And this, when I retired from law, which is in 1999, used to go to 36 volumes. Itne laws hai hamare desh mein. Do you think France has a law on female feticide? Do you think America has a law on dowry? Do you think Japan has a law on manual scavenging? Is India more advanced? That's why we're having these laws. So these laws are not a matter of ye garv ki baat nahi hai. These are matters to be essentially ashamed of. You shouldn't need these laws. They don't have the laws because they don't have the problem. So we should not have the problem. But by passing laws, we are not solving the problem. Because we have now instituted a system in which we pass a law and then we bypass it. So anything you talk about in the world, whether it's the simplest thing, which, how many of us wear helmets when we are riding a two-wheeler? Now, there's a law which is not meant for some other third person, yeah. Sir to hamara hi hai. Lekin kabhi apne baal kharab hoenge, kabhi kuch aur wajah se, waqt nahi hai. Bas main to aadha kilometer ja raha hoon. वजह कोई भी हो, वी डोंट फॉलो इट. एंड एज अ रिजल्ट डेथ और ब्रेन इंजरी लीडिंग टू पैरालिसिस बाय टू व्हीलर्स, इंडिया इज नंबर वन इन द वर्ल्ड. नाउ दीज आर, वन कैन गिव मिलियंस ऑफ एग्जांपल्स ऑफ दिस. सो द लॉज आर नॉट सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स, द लॉज आर ओनली क्रिएटिंग अ जरिया वेरी ऑफन फॉर वेरियस पीपल हु आर पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट मशीनरी टू एक्सट्रैक्ट ब्राइब्स इन रिटर्न फॉर द लॉज. प्रॉब्लम वहीं का वही है, लेकिन उसका दुरुपयोग के बारे में सबसे ज्यादा बात होगी, उसके उपयोग के बारे में बहुत कम हो जाता है. सो आई थिंक द टाइम इज कम फॉर अस टू लुक एट आवरसेल्फ्स एंड रियलाइज दैट इफ वी आर द प्रॉब्लम, वी आर ऑल्सो द सोल्यूशन. एंड दिस थिंग आई एम श्योर यू हैव हर्ड अ मिलियन टाइम्स एंड आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिटेन यू ऑल विद इट, कि गांधी जी सेड बी द चेंज यू वॉन्ट टू सी. And it's very easy to say that. But I understand that there are very important reasons why that does not happen. So we have to accept this first, I think. I think we have to look at ourselves in the mirror, we have to know who we are, and then try and work as to what the solution could be. So the problem is us, the solution is us, but why aren't we? If this is so obvious, why aren't things changing? So this is a very important thing which I'd like to come to, and it's a slightly concept heavy thing, so bear with me. It may sound like a classroom, but I think it's an important concept to understand. See, what happens is that there are two kinds of goods. Ashka spoke about things which are in the private sphere, we are quick to adopt. Now what happens is that for the private sphere, I don't need to ask anybody. I want to have a mobile phone, I have the money, I go buy it, I start using it. But if I want to do something in the public sphere, or I want to use a vehicle, I want to use a better vehicle, I have to just have the money for it and I can use it. But if I want good traffic, it does not depend only on my behavior. I might follow all the traffic rules in the world, but sometimes you can get beaten up for following traffic rules. I'll tell you a story which happened to a colleague of mine. So a guy called Suresh Bhatia. To hua ye to hamari office se wo nikla kareeb raat ke 10 ya 10:30 baj gaye the. He lives, let's say, 20 kilometers from the office. And he stopped at the first signal. So this very fancy BMW came up behind him and he started horning furiously. So Suresh just threw his hands up and pointed out at the red light. So the guy got even more hassled. This went on for some time. And then after some time, the light changed. And Suresh drove off. You'll be surprised, this is in Bombay I'm talking about. Suresh drives ahead, this guy with his BMW, young guy in his 20s, comes, slams the car across, blocks Suresh, gets out of his car and says, "Kya samajhte ho yaar apne aap ko? Aamir Khan banna chahte ho?" This really happened. This really happened. So, what happens is that I want a cleaner city, I don't litter. But by my not littering, the city does not become clean. So, what happens is, that in order to get a change in any social thing, you need a large number of followers. Unless you reach a tipping point in terms of the number of followers, you're not going to see a change with your individual behavior. What is the second reason why we don't change? You know, we all talk about be the change you want to see, be the change you want to see, but we can't actually do it because the many things which we want to change in the public sphere, unless the government is also doing the change, nothing happens. I'll give you a story. Like, the scientific way of dealing with waste is to separate dry and wet. And wet compost kiya jata hai, usse biogas ban sakta hai, fertilizer ban sakta hai, kahi kaam ki cheeze banti hai. Kahi bhi ye desh mein nahi hota hai. Everywhere the waste is mixed. Now, the government passed a law, as always, SWM 2000. And the Supreme Court was also monitoring it. So much for the Supreme Court. And it's been in force for the last 15 years. Usse ye hua hai ki the BMC, which is the Bombay Municipal Corporation, has the right to fine a person who does not give segregated waste 25,000 rupees for mixing dry and wet waste. To bhale aapne hum log dete hain. Ek alag bag hai, ek alag bag hai. But the municipal van which comes to collect it promptly mixes the two bags together. So, usse kuch hota nahi hai. So, over a period of time, what's happened is people have become cynical and they have stopped segregating their waste. So, sab saath mein hi dete, including I, kyunki kuch hone wala to hai nahi. Wahan jaake wahi मिक्स जो होना है वो मिक्स ही होना है. सो बेसिकली इट्स वेरी इजी टू से बी द चेंज यू वांट टू सी, बट यू मे वांट टू सी इट, यू मे ट्राई एंड बी द चेंज, बट द चेंज वोंट हैपन. बिकॉज फॉर दैट चेंज टू हैपन, डिमांड फॉर दैट चेंज हैज टू रीच अ टिपिंग पॉइंट. सो व्हेन 80% ऑफ पीपल और 90% ऑफ पीपल फॉलो ट्रैफिक रूल्स, then the 10% who don't follow, they become offenders. Right now what's happening is exactly the other way around. 10% of people, ye to bewakoof hai yaar, ye to jhagde mein hi padte hai, kahin bhi jata hai jhagde mein padta hai. So he becomes an idiot. What we need to do is we need to raise the percentage of idiots in this country. We need to get the idiots who are following things and doing things the right way from 10% to 90%, so that बाकी जो है उनको लोग इडियट कहना शुरू करें. आज लोग हमें इडियट कहते हैं. सो इन अ वर्ड द एंटायर एफर्ट ऑफ सत्यमेव जयते विच वी हैव ट्राइड टू डू इज नॉट जस्ट टू लुक एट द मैन इन द मिरर, बट इज टू ट्राई एंड क्रिएट अ डिमांड फॉर सोशल गुड्स सो दैट वी टेक इट टू अ टिपिंग पॉइंट, सो दैट द वंस हु आर नॉट डूइंग थिंग्स करेक्टली विल गेट आइसोलेटेड एंड विल ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू चेंज. So basically the whole approach of the show was therefore to, I mean, this is a slide which is, we did a lot of research, etc. And we take nearly a year of research work before we go on air. So the episodes are not created while they are on air. They were all researched a good 12 months, sometimes 18 months before that. And it is only then that we shoot the entire season in one go and we go on air. Now I'm showing you this slide not as bragging rights, but I'm showing you this slide for only one reason, is that what we discovered. First, let me tell you what the mahal was like when we started the show. When we started with the show, many people told us that, look, you're going to do a show only on social issues. Bahut dry hoga. Akhbar mein ye baatein aati rehti hai, news mein bhi aati rehti hai, koi dekhega nahi. But what we discovered is that if people feel कि इससे वाकई कोई चेंज हो सकता है, देन पीपल आर नॉट ओनली विलिंग टू वॉच, दे आर विलिंग टू एंगेज विद दिस शो इन मल्टीपल वेज. सो वी गॉट एन इनॉर्मस रिस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम सिविल सोसाइटी, नॉट ओनली इन टर्म्स ऑफ द व्यूअरशिप. समथिंग लाइक 1 in 2 इंडियंस हैज वॉच्ड एटलीस्ट 1 एपिसोड ऑफ सत्यमेव जयते. एंड पार्ट ऑफ द रीजन फॉर दैट, नहीं डोंट क्लैप, आई एम जस्ट शेयरिंग विद यू बिकॉज दीज आर स्टोरीज ऑफ होप. आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू शेयर विद यू अ लिटिल बिट, बिकॉज समटाइम्स वी कैन गेट वेट डाउन by what we see. What I'm saying is that we realized is that aap baat us prakar se karoge, where we are not talking down to you or, you know, trying to give gyan. We are just sharing with you a common problem which all of us feel emotionally as Indians. You know, wherever I go, I ask a question, ki are you happy with the way your country is right now? How many people are happy? Put your hand up. And how many people feel ki yaar isme badlav aane ki bahut zarurat hai? Put your hand up now. So this is such a beautiful thing that all of us here, who are, I would like to believe, extremely capable of doing wonders, and many of us go on to create wonders. I mean, the IITs and engineering colleges of this country have created wonders all over the world. Why is it that we are not able to change our own country, our own situation? And I believe that that potential has now opened up like never before. So I just want to share with you the kind of staggering level of feedback that we had. On Twitter, we had something like 4.5 billion, not million, billion impressions. So that's the level of conversations which the show, created. I mean, after every episode, we used to trend number one worldwide. Our opening episode, which was on female feticide, the full episode video views have gone into, 40 lakhs or something like that, which is, I mean, other than music videos, which are, watched for other reasons and they're very short, no show anywhere in the world, you look at Oprah, you look at anything, is even close to the kind of views that we have. The number of letters we had, I mean, when we did a show on child sexual abuse, we had 15 lakh letters coming to us from all over the world, including many people who were coming out with what unki aapbeeti, what had occurred to them in their childhood. So clearly, this is something which is waiting to happen, and I think India is ripe. It's absolutely ripe for change, and especially I think I see it among young people. कि वो convinced कि यार जैसे पुराने हालात थे वैसे हम लोग नहीं जिएंगे, हम लोग definitely कुछ ना कुछ change करेंगे. And I think that what happened after 16 December in Delhi, and which had its reverberations all over the country, is a fantastic example of the kind of power that the youth have to bring about change. The other thing I want to tell you is that we should not be cynical about government. It's very easy to be cynical about government, but don't be cynical about it. We were not sure at all how the episode would be received, but we were absolutely thrilled and delighted that many governments and of different political parties responded extremely dynamically and extremely swiftly to our episodes. I'll just give you one example. I'll give you two examples. The first is our opening episode was on female feticide. And in that episode, we had taken out a signature campaign, which millions of people all over India supported. And the signature campaign was that in Rajasthan, two journalists, Shripal Shaktawat and Meena Sharma, had done a sting operation over a period of, I think, 15 months, in which they had captured 130 doctors on camera doing sonographies, determining the sex, and then offering to abort the female child for as little as 2,000 rupees, 3,000 rupees. And we played the portions of the sting on air also, in which the doctors say absurd things like, you know, the decoy asks ki, what do I do with the body? Say, koi nahi, thaili mein dalke yamuna mein phek dena. Matlab, there's a level of cynicism and callousness which is appalling. Although the stings gave conclusive proof, the doctors got off completely scot-free, and the journalists who had done the stings were harassed for 6 or 7 years. They were made to run around as witnesses in every court over there. No trial was even begun properly. And if the journalists didn't turn up, they used to be sent arrest warrants. Ki aap witness hai, aap aaye kyun nahi? After our episode aired and after the entire country supported the signature petition, Amir went, our episode aired on Sunday. On Thursday, he went and met the then Chief Minister of Rajasthan. That same night, the Chief Minister met the Chief Justice of the Rajasthan High Court and asked that fast-track courts be set up. And within a week, the fast-track courts were set up. And inside of a year, 30 cases were concluded and the doctors were convicted. And because of that, the child sex ratio in Rajasthan improved by 30 points over a period of 2 years. So when I say 30 points, it's important to understand 30 per thousand. Now you have to multiply that by the number of births. So it's tens of thousands of girl lives which have been saved. A similar thing happened in Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, it was even more dramatic. It increased by 50 points. Now, this didn't happen only at the level of government. This happened at the level of civil society also. We did an episode on alcoholism. And the heart of that episode was that alcoholism is a disease. And that if it's a disease, it can be cured. So an alcoholic does not need to be condemned. He needs to be understood and treated the way you treat any other patient. And Alcoholics Anonymous is an organization which does this completely free of cost. So we flashed the Alcoholics Anonymous helpline number on the show. Now, Alcoholics Anonymous, in something like 60 or 70 years of existence, had altogether 35,000 members or 40,000 members. You can only be a member if you're an alcoholic. And in something like a month after the show aired, they had 4.5 lakh people who got into rehabilitation to get out of alcoholism. Now you can imagine 4.5 lakh people getting into rehab, how many lives get affected by, you know, one alcoholic affects at least 10 lives. So what we discovered is that government also responds, civil society also responds. Hame sirf karna hai. So here's a golden opportunity we felt, and that's what encouraged us to continue with the show in a big way. The other slide on your right is about the Madhya Pradesh government. It's about generic medicines. You know, the medicines which we buy in this country are all branded. So you buy a particular brand. You don't buy paracetamol, you buy Crocin. You don't buy ibuprofen, you buy Brufen. But in most parts of the world, including the United States of America, 70 to 80% of all medicines sold are generic medicines, where they are sold by the name of the salt. So paracetamol is a salt. Crocin is a brand. So the point is that if you were to sell it by the generic name, the cost is sometimes 1/10, 1/20, even 1/100 of the cost of a branded medicine. So suddenly, instead of spending, you know, people who are chronic diseases, diabetes, kidney failure, hypertension, so you might be spending 500 rupees a month, 600 rupees a month easily on your medicine bill, sometimes much more, which for a poor person can be a substantial portion of what they earn. But if it is generic, it will suddenly come down to 8 rupiah, 10 rupiah, 12 rupiah. So the Madhya Pradesh government opened up in every district in that state generic medicine shop. So aap kahin bhi aap sarkari hospital mein jaiye, aapko har district mein almost at near free rates you can get your medicine quota. So what we discovered is that when people, and why did they do this? I think an important part of it is because a demand was created for a social good. So when the government feels, when people in power feel that this is what our electorate wants, this is how we can get votes, and I think that's a good thing. There's a good reason to get a vote. Yeah, to help people is a good reason to get a vote. I think the whole dynamic changes. And I think the challenge for us to bring about change is how do we create this dynamic so that it extends to more and more spheres, so that people are demanding good things in large numbers. So I'm going to end now by saying that I think that the way to do this is not some big revolution. I think in this country is too vast. I think the biggest change that we can bring about is if each of us decides that other than this selfishness which we have about our own careers, we want to go ahead in our careers, we want to maybe go abroad, we want a better house, we want a better car, we want so many things. Ye karna hi chahiye. But saath saath, can we be selfish for the country and decide that there is some one thing which I'm going to decide I'm doing for society, I'm doing for my community, I'm doing for my country. What that thing is, I think each of us has to decide. It could be something to do with the education of a child. It could be something to do with solid waste management in your area. It could be anything, because nobody knows your reality better than you. But if we can find it within ourselves to be selfish, not only for ourselves, but to be selfish for the country, I think then we'll have taken a giant step towards making this the kind of country that we all dream of, and which we know this country has got immense potential. We have everything here. In fact, one of the things that we discovered in Satyamev Jayate, in our research, is that there is no problem in this country that has not already been solved. Might sound odd, but every problem in this country, there are extremely capable people who are working on it and who have solved it. They have a technical solution, they have a social solution, but unfortunately, there is no scale. So, कहीं एक गांव में implement हो रहा है, कहीं तालुके में implement हो रहा है, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा district में implement हो रहा है. But देश के level के ऊपर, we are somehow not able to come together as a people in order to implement it. So, our journey has been primarily, if I have to sum up, and that's got to do with the topic, is that for far too many things, na, we are not getting out trying to hit a six on the boundary. We are getting out hit wicket. We are stumping ourselves. We are preventing ourselves from achieving our potential as a people. And because of that, it is also equally easy at some level. Ki hum sab agar pran kar le ki isko badalna hai, I think that we have the potential to within 5 years completely transform this country and make it to the kind of country that we all dream of. And as a show, we are trying to carry on these conversations, which is why I'm putting up these details. Because I think we need many, many conversations and many, many initiatives from millions of us if we are to go towards where we all want to be. So thanks a lot, guys. And I'm really looking forward to your questions. You can clap now if you want. You have to. There's too much of stunned silence. It was making me feel awkward.
All of us saw that there is a vast difference between public section and private section. And now we can say that the public section is just because of political issues like corruption, and very little good people are coming into political field. So how can we solve it? This political problem.
See, I think the political problem, there are two answers, two parts to my answer. The first part to the answer is that, of course, we need more good people in politics. So if you're politically inclined, please go into politics. And I think a lot of young people from highly educated backgrounds have been getting into politics over the last 2 or 3 years. And I think that although there are setbacks and many things which disturb us about that, which are happening even as we speak, but I think overall, over a period of time, more such things will keep happening. But the second part of it is that, see, ultimately, good politics is not going to happen only by good people getting into politics. Good politics is going to happen when we demand good politics. I'll tell you some stories which have got to do with our experience when we did an episode on the criminalization of politics. And we traveled extensively through the heartland of India, through Madhya Pradesh, through Uttar Pradesh, through Bihar, through Jharkhand. I mean, these states collectively account for almost half of the seats in the Lok Sabha, Tamil Nadu. And this is what we found. Now, here's a story. A journalist friend of ours was at a marriage, and a member of parliament was also over there. That member of parliament is accused of, I think, 6 murders and dacoity, rape, falatala. So the journalist friend expressed surprise to the MP ki aap sab aapko bulaya shaadi pe. So he's saying, sirf is shaadi pe nahi bulaya, aap meri gaadi ki yahan chaliye. So they went to his car. It was an SUV, fancy SUV. Wo car puri ladi hui thi with gifts. Saadiyan thi aur har saadi ke saath ek envelope tha. Har envelope mein 5000 rupaye the. So the criminal MP told this journalist friend of ours ki I have to attend at least 50 more weddings before I can go home. And he's saying, ye aaj ki baat nahi, ye roz ki baat hai. In the wedding season, this is all that I'm doing. And let me tell you why they call me. Because when they call me, they make sure that they get a photo op and they put a photo also with me. Wo photo prominently ghar pe lagaya jayega. Uske baad, thane ka problem ho, tehsil ka problem ho, quarrelsome neighbor ke saath ladai jhagda ho, ye so and so dada ya bhaiya ya jo bhi usko aap kahenge, daku jo hai, ye ekdam hamara ghar jaisa sambandh hai. All problems are solved. Now what has happened is that over a period of time, the good people in politics have got completely edged out, thrown out, destroyed by this element. And who has destroyed them? Who has destroyed them? Ask yourself the question. We met so many people of the kind of background that you mentioned. Koi engineer hai, koi doctor hai, koi accountant hai, highly educated people, sab kuch chhod chhad ke nahi main apne logon ke liye kaam karun. Ek banda tha jo is tarike se UP ke ek gaon mein ki jahan bahut zyada pollution thi nadi mein, usne pure gaon walon ko ikatta kiya, district ke logon ko ikatta kiya, wo pollution ruka gaya, the nadi was revived. So he, matlab uski ek pukar par pura district utarta tha wo nadi wale agitation ke liye. But when it came to the assembly elections, he lost his deposit. Because log aisa leader chahte hai na ki kaam ka ho, ki uske ek phone pe na thanedar kaap jaye. नहीं तो क्या काम है, काम करवा ही नहीं सकते आप. अगर हमारा काम नहीं करवा सकते तो आप हमको कायदा कानून मत पढ़ाइए, आप हमारा काम करवाइए, फिर आप कैसे करवाते हैं वो आप, इट्स योर बिजनेस. नो, दिस इज अ प्रैग्मेटिक एटीट्यूड विच वी एज इंडियंस हैव कम टू अडॉप्ट. देयर इज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्ड एसोसिएशन फॉर डेमोक्रेटिक राइट्स, ADR, विच मॉनिटर्स फॉर द लास्ट 15 ईयर्स द नंबर ऑफ क्रिमिनल्स इन पॉलिटिक्स. कितने रेप अक्यूज्ड है, कितने मर्डर अक्यूज्ड है, कितने डेकॉइड अक्यूज्ड है, एंड दे हैव लिटिगेटेड एंड दे हैव बीन सॉलिटरी वॉरियर्स इन दिस फील्ड एंड वंडरफुल पीपल डूइंग वंडरफुल वर्क. प्लीज गो टू देयर वेबसाइट ADR. एंड एवरी ईयर, एवरी इलेक्शन, द नंबर ऑफ क्रिमिनल्स इन पॉलिटिक्स इज इंक्रीज्ड. वी डिड एन एपिसोड जस्ट बिफोर दिस लोकसभा इलेक्शन ऑल्सो ऑन इट, इन विच वी हैड अपील टू पीपल, क्योंकि ये इन्फॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल. And ADR को आप बस SMS भेजिए, you will get to know the background of all your candidates. पढ़ाई कितनी है, income कितना है, criminal cases कितने हैं. और हमने सिग्नेचर कैंपेन भी करवाया. सिग्नेचर कैंपेन में हमको करीब करीब 1 crore वोट्स वी हैड गॉट, विच इज़ अ हेल ऑफ अ लॉट. आई मीन इट्स प्रॉब्ली वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट सिग्नेचर कैंपेन्स एनी वे इन द वर्ल्ड. बट डिस्पाइट दैट द ट्रूथ इज that this Lok Sabha saw a further increase in the number of criminal candidates who have got elected. And they belong to every political party. Ek political party ki baat nahi, har political party ki baat hai. So clearly, unless we demand different kinds of politicians, the good guys may come, but they'll get destroyed. We need to decide ki under no circumstances will we vote for the criminals. Then things will change. And we have to move towards that tipping point. Are we moving? I don't know. On this question, I'm a little agnostic.
Sir, in our India, there are courts at every level, like tehsil, state.
Speak a little louder, I can't hear you.
Sir, in our India, there are courts like at tehsil level, district level, state level, and lot of cases are filing day by day. But the decision by judges are like pending so much time. Are you working on this issue or what is the problem?
Yeah. This is about judicial delay. Judicial delay in India is a world record delay. And seriously, man, if there's a world record Guinness book, mein, hamara definitely number. I used to be a lawyer, so I can tell you something about this. In the year 1989, I joined the bar and the office I was working in, there were civil suits pending which had been filed in the year 1975. So 75 wala suit was pending in 1989. तो हमारे ऑफिस में ये बात होती थी कि 14 साल लगेंगे यार क्लियर होने के लिए, लेकिन 14 साल नहीं लगेंगे क्योंकि व्हेन आई लेफ्ट लॉ विच वाज इन 1999, वो 1975 वाला केस जो था ना वो तब भी आया नहीं था ट्रायल के लिए. सो इन बॉम्बे जैसी जगह में आपको 30-40 मतलब योर ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन विल नॉट गेट टू सी अ केस यू फाइल. सो इट इज़ अ कैलामिटस सिचुएशन, इट इज़ अ कैटास्ट्रोफिक सिचुएशन. And it needs to be dealt with on a war footing. We need to do an episode on it. And in fact, we have begun the research also on it. So hopefully we'll do an episode and most probably end up in jail because of that.
So there are two cases. Thames of London, Thames River of London was as dirty as Ganga of India. But within a few years, it was cleared to its original position. In India, we are having Ganga Action Plan, but it has not cleaned up the river. But, and there is also one case, when the rapes were occurring in Delhi, then no huge steps were taken. But when Obama had to come to India, then approximately 15,000 cameras were installed. So what are your thoughts? Should we call Obama to take a dip at Haridwar?
Not a bad idea.
Not a bad idea at all. But even then, you will not be able to do it. आप हाथ के बल चलो, आप इस प्रकार से नहीं कर पाएंगे. सी द थिंग अबाउट द वी डिड एन एपिसोड ऑन वाटर विच वॉज द 10th एपिसोड ऑफ आर फर्स्ट सीजन. आई वुड इन्वाइट यू ऑल बिकॉज यू आर ऑल साइंटिफिक पीपल एंड इट्स एन एपिसोड आई एम पर्टिकुलरली प्राउड ऑफ. वी वर वॉर्न्ड बाय द चैनल कि कोई देखेगा नहीं, पानी के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, इतना सूखा विषय हो ही नहीं सकता. बट एनी वे डिस्पाइट द आयरनी ऑफ दैट दोज वर्ड्स, आई थिंक वी मेड एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड एंगेजिंग एपिसोड. एंड वॉट वी डिस्कवर्ड is this, that aap kitna bhi kharch kijiye, you can spend trillions, you can spend the entire GDP of India on not cleaning up the Ganga, it is not going to get cleaned like this. Because there's a very very simple principle that so long aap ye sochiye na ki aap ek bartan pani mein agar continuously uske andar aap tatti phekte rahenge to aap side mein kitna bhi aap kharch kar lijiye wo saaf kaise rahega. And that's what we are doing. The Yamuna in Delhi, and this is not a laughing matter at all, it's a tragic matter because we all love our rivers. The Yamuna in Delhi consists only of the sewage water of Delhi. There is no water left in the Yamuna because all the water of the Yamuna has already been removed in the barrage at Haryana, which is 120 kilometers upstream. So baki jo Delhi ka jitna bhi flow hai is only sewage. If you stop that sewage flow, there is no water left in the Yamuna. Which is why the bacterial coliform count and all, we had given that on the show. Manoj Mishra ji from Jio Abhiyan, Jio Yamuna Abhiyan had given the exact numbers. Like, we are not 5 times permissible limits, we are not 10 times permissible limits of pollutants, we are like 5 million times. Because there are only pollutants, it's not that there is water, there are pollutants and there's a little water with it. So, if we want to clean up our rivers, it's going to happen first and foremost if we stop polluting them. Otherwise, a river, you know, nadi ka matlab hi hai, Hindustani mein, nadi ka matlab behna, जो चीज बहती है वो नदी है और जो बहती नहीं है वो नदी है ही नहीं. सो द फ्लो ऑफ द रिवर विल क्लीन इट. आप पॉल्यूशन बंद करिए, आपको क्लीन करने की जरूरत नहीं है, आपको पॉल्यूशन रोकने की जरूरत है. बट टू स्टॉप द पॉल्यूशन एवरी सिंगल म्युनिसिपल कमिश्नर ऑन ऑल द सिटीज ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द गंगा एक्चुअली नीड्स टू बी इन जेल एज पर आवर एक्ट्स. इंडस्ट्रीज पोर पॉल्यूटेंट्स इनटू आवर रिवर्स मतलब विद अ सिनिसिज्म व्हिच इज अनबिलीवेबल. इन द स्टेट आई बिलोंग टू महाराष्ट्र द शुगर इंडस्ट्री व्हिच इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट पॉल्यूटर्स. You know, the river, I mean, you'll weep if you see it. The river, if this is the bank of the river, no? There is a 3-foot height of foam. The chemicals in it induce a foam. It looks like snow on the water. It floats on the entire length of the river. This is a river. And this is not happening secretly. Aap ye zara sochiye, river mein aap secretly nahi kar sakte, khule saryam ho raha hai. और जिसके लिए लॉ बनी है, सख्त लॉ है, एक लॉ इंप्लीमेंट नहीं होता, एक दिन के लिए एक लॉ इंप्लीमेंट नहीं होता. सो व्हाट आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट? आई हैव नो आइडिया. आई हैव एब्सोल्युटली नो आइडिया हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू क्लीन द गंगा. एंड दिस इज नॉट द जॉब ओनली ऑफ पॉलिटिशियन. दिस इज गॉट टू डू विद आवर सिनिसिज्म. द वे वी डंप कचरा इनटू आवर होली रिवर्स, व्हाट आर वी थिंकिंग ऑफ? How will we have a clean river if we dump kachra into it? So that attitude ये बन गया है कि अभी इतने लोग हैं इतना तो होगा यार. तो कोई इस बात को बुरा नहीं समझता है, बस थोड़ा यहाँ वहाँ you express regret, but there is no belief, there is no real belief that this can be cleaned. So we have to. Have you ever heard of this becoming a political issue? Because to make it a political issue, it means that you will have to take on all the industries that are doing this and tell them that unless you install an effluent treatment plant, that effluent treatment plant actually works every day and only tested water can be discharged into the river, you cannot function, you will be shut down no matter what the consequences are. We have to create that demand, we have to create that mahal in which that can happen. That is not happening anywhere in the country, and this unites us from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Jitna bhi India, unity and diversity, no? The unity unfortunately is in things like this. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, we believe that we have the right to pollute our rivers, to dirty our roads, to filthy our streets. This is the sad fact. And which is why I feel that so government needs to act, and but people need to act in a huge way. Where have we expressed our anger? Itna bada apman ho gaya hamari nadiyon ka. What have we done as a people? In what form have we expressed our opinion so that those in power feel ki yaar ye itna bada issue hai na ki iska agar hum kuch karenge nahi to lafda ho jayega. Jaise misal ke taur par 16 December ke baad mujhe lagta hai ki pure desh ne apna akrosh vyakt kiya, and it expressed it in such a way that all the parties got together and passed a law. That law may not have solved the problem, but at least there was some response. I'm saying, can we show our anger in such a way that the political parties get together and say that if you pollute, you're shut down? But that's not happening. That's not happening. And for that, we are responsible also.
Sir, news and media are the eye-openers of the society. Do you think our eye-openers are lost in gaining TRPs?
News and media should be the eye-openers of our society. I don't think they are.
Presently, they aren't. But
I don't know what they are lost in. I think news and media suffer from multiple problems. Number one, we have to understand that news... See, news and media, like any other thing, are like any other profession. In India, there are great doctors, lawyers, architects, accountants, even politicians. And there are people who are really, you know, are not doing what they should be doing. I think the same thing is happening in news and media. Ki news and media mein bahut achha kaam bhi hota hai, lekin bahut zyada bura kaam hota hai. And I get frightened when I see Times Now. I feel very frightened. कि एक आदमी इतना चिल्ला चिल्ला के किसी को बात करने का मौका नहीं देता, एंड ही इज सपोज टू बी द नंबर वन एंकर. इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ फियर. इफ दिस इज व्हाट वी थिंक इज गुड, देन मतलब परहैप्स मेनी थिंग्स गेट एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. सो वी आर रिवॉर्डिंग दिस बाय वॉचिंग दैट. वी आर रिवॉर्डिंग दिस. आई बिलीव ही वेंट मैड लास्ट नाइट ऑन टीवी येलिंग एट द इंडियन क्रिकेट टीम. he should certainly try and play a few matches.
Thank you, sir.
So my question is this, that would you like to make an episode for the reservation system in India? In
this
education?
Where are you?
Sir.
Yeah, hi.
So my
question. Yeah, the question has been put to us several times, and in fact we did one episode which indirectly touched upon it, but not quite. So yes, we would like to. The answer to your question is yes. Like the one on the judicial system, we would like to do one on this.
Sir. On this side, sir. So I want to ask this. When I went to my village for the first time,
where's your village?
Madhya Pradesh.
Okay.
Dowry and this sex selective abortion and many other things. This intercaste marriages are strictly prohibited and everything are prevalent there very highly. I tried to convince my people that I, being a student in a renowned school in Surat, and which is a considerably big city, I tried to explain them this these all things is not good for the society and you should try to change this. But they told me that you are a young fellow, you don't know the world, and you will be yourself shunted from this society if you follow this. So better keep it up to your books and up to your exams, and don't try to spread it over here, because we cannot change. So what, as a young person, as a student of IIT, can I do to convince those people, at least my village, that this is wrong, or you should try to change?
What's your name?
Abhishek.
Abhishek, superb question. Yeah, I loved your question, and hats off to you that you even tried to do this, because I can imagine how difficult it is. I'm going to give a slightly, I'll share with you what I feel about this. The first thing, Abhishek, is I want to ask you a question. Ki 500 years later from today, assuming that the earth has survived, Homo sapiens has survived, neither of which I don't think is going to happen. But let's imagine for the sake of argument that Homo sapiens and the earth survive. Forget 500 years, 200 years later, 200 to 50 years later. Do you think that people, that intercaste marriages will be forbidden 200-300 years later?
I cannot predict.
I don't think so. I don't think so. I think the tide of history is on our side. The question is that right now the tide of history is claiming victims. Badlav to aane wala hai. Dunya ki koi taakat is badlav ko nahi rok sakti. Because at the heart of the problem is the fact that there is gender inequality. At the heart of the problem is a woman is supposed to be inferior to a man. And therefore, a woman should not have any choice in any matter. So the whole system is designed at a deeper level, we can discuss this, to make sure that women have no freedom of choice. Whether you like it or not, more and more women are going to get educated. More and more women are going to get better and better jobs. More and more women are going to be visible on the roads and the streets. More and more women are going to be available in positions of power. And with that, change will come. Change will come in 50 years, 100 years, 150 years, 200 years. So the tide of history is with us. Things are not going to be the way they were. The problem is that history, in its form in which it is unfolding in our country, is claiming lives. So when you say that I want to do an intercaste wedding, you are threatened with either excommunication or violence of some kind or the other. Or if you talk about it, you're threatened with violence. Maybe not for yourself personally, but वहाँ बात करने जाओ तो लोग कहेंगे हम आपको जान से मार डालेंगे. लेकिन यही लोगों के granddaughters, trust me, will be exercising their freedom of choice. So that change is going to come. Now we have to try and accelerate that process of change. How can that process be accelerated? I think the fact that you're showing the courage to do that, I think is great. And you have to find devious ways sometimes to carry messages. So for example, if you were to engage with the villagers on something else, I don't know what your specialization is, but ho sakta hai, I mean, I'm just throwing it to you. You'll find some analogous kind of thing. Maan lijiye aap hydrological engineer hai, and your village needs your expertise in some way. Now, when you get the opportunity to serve your village for hydrology, you also get an opportunity to interact with them, to interact with you, to talk to them about other things. Ideas are also infectious. Bad ideas infectious hai, good ideas be infectious hai. We have to infect with good ideas, and we have to seize opportunities depending on the cultural climate that is prevalent. Now, the way I'm talking here standing in IIT Roorkee before you all students, I obviously can't speak in the same way with a khap panchayat which is in Muzaffarnagar, which is less than 50 kilometers from here. If I try and talk in the same way, it's very unlikely that I'm going to get to home in any kind of reasonable shape. So, but you still need to have that conversation. I'm saying we need to have a conversation which is possible under those circumstances. And you said for the first time you went, so perhaps you've also not been in the village for a long time. And I think that the important thing now is actually those kind of conversations. When you talk to people who are already convinced, the English phrase is like preaching to the choir. अरे वो already मान गया है ऊपर से आप उसको पटाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं उसकी ज़रूरत नहीं है. एक्चुअली ज़रूरत है उस बंदे से बात करने की या उस बंदी से बात करने की जो आपकी बात से सहमत नहीं है. एंड वी हैव टू हैव दोज कॉन्वर्सेशन. इन फैक्ट आर एंटायर एफर्ट इन सत्यमेव जयते वाज ओनली टू टॉक टू पीपल हु डोंट अग्री विद अस. एंड द ओनली वे यू कैन टॉक अकॉर्डिंग टू मी यू हैव टू वेपन्स एंड दीज आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टू वेपन्स फॉर एनीथिंग आई बिलीव इन लाइफ. And the weapons are, number one is friendship and the other is love. If we can find love in our hearts for somebody who's not like us, for somebody who disagrees with us, for somebody who feels ki yaar ye bahut galat aadmi hai, uske bawajood bhi hum apne dil mein agar mohabbat rakh sakte hain, then we find within it the possibility of conversations. And conversations ultimately, you know, koi insaan bura nahi hota. Wo alag hota hai, uske circumstances alag hai, uski parvarish alag hui hai. I was in IIT Kharagpur, I think a month back, and this boy got up and he asked me this question. He said, ki, you know, I'm in love with a girl and come from a very conservative family. So how do I tell my father? Because my father will just blow up. So I told him, I know I'm digressing, but I'm just seeing, see if it's useful for you. If it's not, ignore. So I told him, see, I've forgotten his name now. I said, see, one important thing you have to understand is your father didn't have a girlfriend. Your father had an arranged marriage. And his father also had an arranged marriage, and his father and father and father before that. So what's happened is, the other second thing is that we have no tradition in our society, no, of having a conversation between son and father. Saying y'all may be exceptions, but by and large in our society, aise nahi hota hai ki, I'm hanging out with my dad, yaar. So, baat kahin dhang se hui nahi hai. To hota ye hai ki father has not spoken to his son and his father didn't speak to him, and you can go back 5,000 years, Baba Adam ke time, conversations nahi hue. So I said, you need to have a conversation with your dad. So he said, how to do that? So I said, do one thing. Tell him, Papa, मुझे आपसे बात करनी है. आई सेड द मोमेंट यू से दैट योर फादर विल बी टेरिफाइड. वो सब बुरी बुरी चीजें सोचने लगेंगे कि पता नहीं ये क्या बोलने वाला है, कि कोई क्राइम किया है, ड्रग्स किया, पता नहीं क्या किया है इसने. तो इसी ने नहीं बताओ बताओ इसी ने नहीं आपको जब फुर्सत होगी ना पापा, उस दिन को हम लोग संडे को आराम से कहीं और जाते हैं ताकि 10 लोग ना हो, हम लोग आराम से बैठ के बात करते हैं. फादर इज फुली साइट. Said, now what's happening is your father's come in with very low expectations about you. So, aap fir kya kariye? Wo meeting ki shuruaat mein you tell your father ki papa, there's something I've been wanting to tell you for a long time. Papa, I really love you. I'm not joking. See, we love our parents, but we don't have a tradition. अभी ये बच्चे कुछ करते होंगे y'all, but like I grew up in a super liberal family, so my father's my friend, but I saw all my friends used to be terrified of their dads. So I said, the moment you say that na, that आपके पापा का दिल पिघल जाएगा. And maybe he has been wanting to talk to you, but he didn't know how to initiate the conversation. तो अक्सर ये होता है कि आप उस कुछ बात करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन आप जानते नहीं कि किस प्रकार से बात करें. Where do you start? मोहब्बत का इजहार करना आसान काम नहीं होता. तो आप इस प्रकार से आप शुरू कीजिए, एंड देन यू टेल हिम दैट. सो ही सेड, अच्छा, बट व्हाट इफ ही डजंट अग्री विथ मी आफ्टर दैट? सो आई सेड, इफ ही डजंट अग्री, देन यू नो व्हाट टू डू एनीवे, यू डोंट नीड मी टू टेल यू दैट. सो आई एम सेइंग, विथ योर with the people in your village, you'll have to find friendship, love, and a conversation. And believe me, if you persist, because love means you don't give up. You don't give up. So aap gyan dene mat jaiye. Main shehri hu, main acche school se hu, main sab kuch janta hu, main aapko sikhaunga. If you go like that, no, they will not accept it. Go low angle. Main aapse seekhna chahta hu. Main aapko samajhna chahta hu. Main aapka dost banna chahta hu. Kyunki main bhi is gaon ka hu. My roots are here and I want to talk to you. Trust me, it will work. Next. So basically you all have woken up after I started speaking about love ka izhar, huh?
No.
So with success comes a lot of criticism. So how do you as an organism like Satyamev Jayate as well as you as an individual take up criticism? And what do you think like we as individuals should take criticism when we try to bring up some change in the society?
There's some very nice phrase on this. Ki basically the person who has doesn't face any criticism, somebody who's not done anything. So I think criticism is par for the course. Anything you do in public life is going to get criticized. And if in creative work, to wo to hona hi hai. So we are quite, how do I put it? I'd like to believe, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I'd like to believe I'm extremely open to criticism. And we faced a lot of hostility. We faced all kinds of criticism. We faced, there are people who stopped talking to me because of the show or things which we've done on it. And now what to do? I've just told my friends one thing. I mean, we did an episode on the medical profession, which didn't go down, unfortunately, very well with them. But there was nothing personal. I mean, we just felt that it was necessary to have a conversation about that. And mere bachpan ke teen sabse aziz dost doctors hai. So I told them that to be my friend, you don't have to like my work, yeah. So I'm like completely cool with the fact that so even at a personal level, I think that if you're a creative person and you're close to criticism, you can't grow. So you have to be open to criticism. You have to.
Excuse me, sir.
And Aamir is very good at this. Matlab Aamir ki itni zyada hum logon ne pitai ki hai for some of his films. And wo itne patiently wo baithega and he listen to people rubbishing him and criticizing him and without ever interrupting or trying to defend himself. Because I think as creative people, we are given the privilege of creating something which is in the public domain. So, humara jo kaam tha, hum logon ne already kar diya. So, we said what we need to. Now, we need to listen. So, in fact, one of the reasons why I like to, I'm here is I want to listen to your criticisms also. So, please feel free. So, don't, if that was a kind of preface to starting to criticize, go for it.
Sir, I have a question. Hello. Yeah. So can we have an offline version of Satyamev Jayate, like organizational? Like we have many NGOs, but you know, like Satyamev Jayate has reached all over India.
Yeah.
And all of us are affected, all of us are watching. But I want to do, but nothing, I have any platform like that, national platform we can start. So do you feel that we have an organizational Satyamev Jayate, an offline version?
See, this has been, what's your name?
Mohammed Sibghatullah.
Mohammed, this has been suggested to us several times. Ki aap Satyamev Jayate NGO bhi banaiye. One gentleman from Chennai, in fact, created a very beautiful kind of whole organizational structure. But what we feel now, Mohammed, is that our strength is not as organizers. Our strength is as communicators. So, hamara jitna bhi, matlab, kam zyada humko aata hai, humko communication mein ruchi hai. So, I feel if we try and become organizers, na, we'll get sucked into something which we are not. So I have blocked it at every stage and I don't want to be an organization at all. I want to continue to be a communicator because I think that our task, na, Mohammed, is to help organizations on the ground. And what we try and do is that we try and help the organizations in multiple ways. Like every organization which features on our show sees a dramatic rise in their membership and volunteers and money raised and work that they are capable of doing. So we have helped so many organizations. Like we've done 24 episodes. We must have raised some 30-35, no, much more. I think the figure was up there. Some 40-50 crores of rupees we must have raised for them. So we are good at helping others. I don't think we'll be good if we try and do work ourselves. I think we'll fail. I don't think we are, it's not our strength.
Sure.
But you should start something, Mohammed. You should start an organization.
Exactly. That I felt, so I asked this question.
No, please. I feel that this country will only change when millions of people take the initiative and do various things.
No, you have, I mean, you have privilege of like, if someone comes under your banner, he will be getting...
You don't have to create a banner, you have to just communicate. Because the moment we create a banner, then it starts a dynamic. We have to do so much work. Is what I feel.
Thank you.
Sir, you just now talk about the communication and conversation between the parents and the students that we are having. But when it comes to girls, there is no conversation. There is always a force.
Yeah.
So how do we cope up with that? Like, when you go out somewhere, you always face this thing. Like, with most of the girls, there is no conversation.
Yeah.
So how do we cope up with that? Like, for most of the girls, all over.
I don't know how you all cope. I think to be born a girl in this country and to deal with all that you all deal, I mean, hats off to you all. Honestly. It's fantastic. I think a round of applause for all the women who are here. I think what we do with our women, I have no words. I can't even imagine. I mean, I have a daughter and as she puts it, there's not one day she can walk out of the house without getting unwanted attention and comments of some kind or the other. I mean, what kind of a life is this? And what kind of a people are we that we are doing this here? So I agree with you that it's there, it needs to change, and it's going to change with, it is going to change. It is changing even as we speak, and we see again and again so many success stories. However bad things are, the truth is in Bombay, I'm just giving you that as an example, you have lakhs of girls, if not millions, going out and working every day, traveling by public transport, taking on the world, making fabulous successes of their lives. Returning home from work alone at 2 a.m. and 3 a.m. in the morning. I'm proud to say that my daughter, who's a singer, because recordings often go on till 2 a.m. and 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. And it was difficult for me as a father to accept that this thing. But she said that, look, it's my, I have to exercise that right. That, and I have to believe in my safety and my ability to deal with the problems with which go with it. And she negotiates all of this, and of course it's difficult, but y'all, how do I put it, y'all are laying the path for your daughters, and things are going to keep getting better, but we're going to have to fight for it. It's not going to happen automatically, and there are going to be, and there are horrible things happening because of that.
Sir, that's a topic and a huge level.
But don't accept it. I'm saying don't accept inequality. We have to make it non-negotiable. Equality is non-negotiable. One favorite question which I have here, and it's a tough one. Is I want to ask everyone here, ki aapki shaadi mein, how many of you all are willing to accept the principle that number one, ki aap aapke mata pita ka paisa ek bhi rupya nahi lenge, because you are all going to be very well qualified and earning well, and that whatever the expenditure on the marriage is going to be shared equally between you and your significant other. How many of you all are willing to promise that? Fantastic. Fantastic. And I'm saying, these are small things, but these are huge things. These are huge things, and we have to make some things non-negotiable. Safety of women, non-negotiable. Equality of gender, non-negotiable. So I know force is being used, but you have to absolutely not accept it.
No, sir, I'm talking that this is on a huge level. Like in the house, if you go, like if you have certain other, like if say homosexuality, if a girl want to go and talk to her mother about her lesbianness, so like that comes into a force, and that's not easily acceptable.
I agree with you. What's your
name? There's a video recently which was viral over the net. I don't know exactly the name, but that was kind. She goes to her mother and she disclosed that she is actually lesbian, and she.
I saw the video.
So my name is Shweta.
Shweta, this video, the mother starts crying, correct?
Yeah, the mother.
And then later on, thoda wo samajhti hai. So I want to tell you, Shweta, that we did an episode on homosexuality, LGBT, which I'm very proud of. And those of you all who find the time, please do go and see it on YouTube or off our site. I want to tell you a story about this. When we decided to do an episode on LGBT, our team ke jo members the na. उसमें से कुछ लोगों ने कहा कि आज तक सत्या आपने जितनी भी पुण्याई कमाई है ना सत्यमेव जयते के जरिए एक एपिसोड के वजह से पूरा जीरो हो जाएगा. डोंट डू दिस एपिसोड. सो खैर वी डिडंट लिसन टू हिम. ऐसे हमारे इंटरनल डिस्कशंस कई सारे होते रहते. वी वर कन्विंस्ड दैट देयर इज गोइंग टू बी अ ह्यूज अप्रोर एंड देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ मतलब violence, and we were pretty sure we'll get arrested. Nothing like that happened. मतलब वो एपिसोड टेलीकास्ट होने के बाद वी रिसीव्ड 15 लाख मैसेजेस आइदर बाय फेसबुक ट्विटर और मेल 15 लाख एंड बारिंग 125 वी डू अ एनालिसिस आल्सो वी हैव अ फॉर्म व्हिच डज दैट एवरी वन ऑफ द अदर्स वाज पॉजिटिव लाइक माय पेरेंट्स I don't think my parents knew anything about homosexuality and my father is mildly I would say homophobic so quite negative matlab kya tum homosexuality ke bare mein baat karte ho he felt ki ye topic hi nahi hai but after seeing the episode his reaction was completely different and I think the reason is because we approached it with a lot of love and the way the stories were told People realize ki no person in the world is a homosexual. He's first and foremost a human being. So first you're a, aap insaan ho, aap ya to boy ho ya girl ho, aur jaise baaki log hote hain world mein waise aap hi ho. Bas aapka sexual preference jo hai, wo thoda alag hai, aur aapke jaise bahut saare log hain, jo alag hai. So I think the space is opening up, Shweta, for conversations, and I was amazed by this. And this SMJ goes to small towns, yeah, gaon kasbe tak pahunch jata hai. And nowhere did we get a violent reaction because when you get a violent reaction, we immediately come to know. People start sending legal notices. Kahin koi vakil case file karta hai, kahin kuch hota hai, kahin kuch hota hai. Kuch nahi hua. So I feel that things are changing. Contrary to what we'd like to believe, things are changing also. And we need to have, we'll need to persist. Abhi kya halat bure lagte hai, aise lagta hai ki yaar, होगा नहीं नहीं लेकिन होगा वी नीड टू परसिस्ट एंड स्टे द कोर्स एंड अगेन एज आई एम टेलिंग यू लव एंड फ्रेंडशिप यूज दैट एज वेपन्स एंड यू कैन फाइंड अ वे टू हैव अ कन्वर्सेशन
सो सर एक बात मैं इंडिया में देख रहा हूँ मतलब जो डिजर्विंग होता है वो पीछे हो जाता है लाइक रिजर्वेशन है और एमपी में भी मैं एमपी से हूँ व्यापम स्कैम हुआ उसमें पैसे के लिए जो पीएमटी की सीट्स थी वो किसी और को दे दी और लाइक आपको ट्रांसफ़र कराना है आप पैसे दे दो ट्रांसफ़र हो जाएगा आपको प्रमोशन कराना है आप पैसे दे दो प्रमोशन हो जाएगा कोई प्रेस्टिजियस जॉब है आप आपकी अगर किसी नेता से अच्छी पहचान है वो कॉल कर देगा तो आपको वो जॉब मिल जाएगी और सर दिस इज़ इंक्रीजिंग डे बाय डे सर ये कम कैसे होगा या हो पाएगा या नहीं हो पाएगा कम
आई डोंट अग्री विद यू दैट दिस इज़ इंक्रीजिंग डे बाय डे इज़ वेरी बैड बट इज़ नॉट इंक्रीजिंग आई थिंक इट्स डिक्रीजिंग आई थिंक थिंग्स आर गेटिंग बेटर बट दे आर सो बैड ना जब Things are so bad, उसमें बदल भी आता है तो अपन को लगता है कि कुछ बदला नहीं है बट इट इज चेंजिंग फॉर द बेटर आई डोंट थिंक इट्स चेंजिंग फॉर द वर्स आई थिंक आर टी आई द मीडिया आई मीन मीडिया कुछ अच्छी बातें भी करता है आई थिंक लिटिल बिट अकाउंटेबिलिटी इज कमिंग इन टू आर कल्चर सी यू टू रिमेंबर एज अ कंट्री ना फर्स्ट वी टू रिमेंबर वे वी केम फ्रॉम जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट आर हिस्ट्री सी एज अ कंट्री ऑन 26 January 1950, we adopted the constitution, correct? And there's a preamble to that constitution. That preamble has the most beautiful words. It says, we the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, democratic, now we've added socialist, secular republic, and to secure to all its citizens, justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. Uske andar jada explanation bhi hai. My question for you is this. That as a country, as a civilization, are we a civilization, and I'm not going to answer this, that has believed in justice? Is it a civilization that has believed in liberty? Is it a civilization that has believed in equality? Equality, aap chahte hain. Kya hum equal rahe hain, itihas mein? And have we believed in bhaichara? Or, as Dr. Ambedkar said on that day, that politically there is equality, But socially and economically, there is no equality. This is a country which is founded on the basis of a jati system. This is a truth of this country. Aap isko inkar nahi kar sakte. So as a result of that, we have not had equality and a merit-based system hamare khoon mein nahi raha hai. We have not encouraged that. We have not practiced that. We are trying it now. And 65 years later, it may look like we have got nowhere. But I think that there has been some progress. We are not where we were in 1947 or 1950. I think things have changed. Things have changed in many respects. I'll give you an example. Like elections. The way money used to be spent during elections in the 90s, I mean, it was crazy. You used to have mics on all the time. Halla, gulla, mayhem. There used to be no question of a debate or baatcheet karne ka koi sawal hi nahi tha. Kuch to aa gaya hai. Now, it's not an ideal world, but it's better than what existed. So, in many respects, including what you're talking about, things aise lag raha hoga ki koi kuch badla nahi hai, lekin badal raha hai. Aur अच्छे के लिए भी बदल रहा है. आई थिंक द चैलेंज बिफोर अस इज हाउ डू वी मेक थिंग्स हैपन मच फास्टर. कि अभी इफ इट्स गोइंग द गाड़ी फर्स्ट गियर में 5 किलोमीटर पर आर पर चल रही है, हाउ डू वी गेट इट इनटू फोर्थ गियर एंड रन एट यू नो 50 किलोमीटर पर आर सो दैट दिस चेंज हैपन्स इन आर लाइफ टाइम. इनफैक्ट आई डेयर से दैट वी कैनॉट मेक दिस चेंज हैपन इन आर लाइफ टाइम. I mean, we have different lifetimes, but I would say in my lifetime, which is, let's say, maybe another 25 years, I can't even imagine what will happen to this country, because with, what you know, 1.5 billion Indians, if we can't get our act together, we are going to implode. So I don't think we have a choice. We have to do it. We have to do it. And we have every ability to do it. Har cheez hai hamare paas.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
So what was your motivation or drive behind
Actually, I'm going to take this as the last question, because I can see quite a lot of are getting restless and maybe have to leave for various things. Those who want to have a further chat, I'll be around. I'm not planning to run anywhere. You know? Makes sense, no? Huh?
So what was your motivation or drive behind thinking of such a show or concept?
What was the motivation behind Satyamev Jayate? The motivation behind Satyamev Jayate was essentially what I've been talking about all afternoon, which is that we need to spark a million conversations which can change the face of the man in the mirror.
So how did it...
uska history kya hai? Uska history ye hai ki what happened is that, you know, Aamir had been approached by many people, TV channels and all, ki aap sir ek show kariye. Do a show on, you know, dance show, reality show, talent show, KBC type show. This had been happening for some time. So Aamir felt that TV is a very powerful medium. Ghar ghar tak pahunchta hai. So he said, if I do TV, I don't want to do an entertainment show. I'm an entertainer anyway in films. TV I want to do on something on social topics. So he, I had done a work with Aamir before. So he met me and he asked me, Satya, what do you think? Have you any thoughts of what we can do? So anyway, we had a long discussion at the end of which, basically, he allowed me to set up a small team. And with that team, we actually went out in the field and began researching and shooting and accumulating material, which helped us to think through what kind of show we want to do. And gradually that thing, so initially we made some documentary films. In 3 months, we shot 6 documentaries. And the idea became a little clearer that we need to have a show which will take unheard voices, voices you've never seen, people you've never seen, voices you've never heard, and present them to the country in a format which will enable them to understand one topic at a time. So that's... And then there were lots of things. Like, one of the important thing for us is that we didn't want to do a show which was going to be a shouting and screaming show. Ki aap iske liye zimmedar hai. Us type ka show hum log nahi banana chahte hain. No, Arnab was going to be there. So we wanted to do a show which will speak the language of love. Because really, anybody who feels ki yaar, main bahut achha hoon, tum bure ho, I feel usse baat aage ja hi nahi sakti. Usse aage ja hi nahi sakti. I think we have to start with the point that हम सब अच्छे हैं और हम सब में कहीं ना कहीं बुराई भी है, और अगर हम कोशिश करें तो बुराई हम सब मिलकर दूर भी कर सकते हैं.